Henry McClelland, welcome back to An Athletic. Nice to see you as always at Gallabank.
Pleased to be here, Peter.
Coming in for a bit of guest commentary with Hizzy for the today's game against Cowden.
Yeah, it will be a guest commentary with Hizzy. Unlikely to get a word in. But I've been fortunate. I watch all the games on the streaming with my season ticket. Gordon's had some good guests in. It's brilliant hearing Spoons again. Oh, it's terrific. But no, it's great that the fans have been able to come in, that we can actually watch it. I just wish we would maybe zoom in a wee bit more in the game with that pixel lot system. It seems awfully far away.
It does, doesn't it?
But hopefully we can get that right as we move forward.
Aye. So it's 4 years since you've been officially involved with the club, but obviously you've been at a lot of games since.
Yeah.
What are you thinking? Progressed or?
I think it's difficult to call this season. You've got to be fair, I've been in the situation before where I've had to deal with situations where the club's maybe been in difficult times, but I think probably a couple of months ago would have been one of the hardest times that the club would have faced since we joined the league. It's like 13, 14 seasons ago now, but at that time I was really worried. I was still getting the old stomach pains and all the worries, and even though I've not been involved for 4 years, it's hard not to feel for the club. You still feel for them, but at that point, gosh, I really was worried that we were going to be in the situation that Brecon's in now. Any club now, with the way the pyramids are, they're going to have a real struggle. There's big money from the Lowland League, Highland League. These clubs are positioning themselves to get into the top 42, and I think the real challenge for us here at Annan is to make sure that we are in this position again. I would say it's long overdue now that we should be up a league and putting everything in place to be in that league above. Could quite easily be a sustainable club in that league when you see others like Montrose, etc. They're no much bigger than Annan. It's just the way. Big challenges, how do we do it? It'll always come down to finance. You get the finance in, but it's more than that. You've seen Brecon have ploughed a lot of money into the second half of the season, allegedly paying big money for some of those players that they've picked up there, and it's not serving them much good. So it's more than just throwing money. A lot of these clubs that are maybe on the fringes of joining senior football, they think money's the answer, but it's a lot more than that. So I think there's big challenges ahead for us. We've escaped this year, but each year that we escape and if we stay in this position, there's always a new club coming in with a lot of wealth, and they'll do the right things. We've seen that with Cove. Edinburgh City's challenging up there as well. So tough times.
Aye.
But I still believe it can be done as long as we put our minds to it, and it would have to be, we'd see the club moving into the league above and staying there for a long period if the right things are done.
Aye. You've obviously before that you're heavily involved with the club for a long, long time.
Yeah.
I've seen a lot of faces come and go and
half, yeah.
Good memories.
Oh, brilliant. I was just thinking this morning there, I think my first season when I joined the club would have been about 77. That was the first time we played in the Scottish Cup. We'd just become SFA members and we played Stranraer, and Jabberjaw's there, he was on the bench for Stranraer. They beat us 3-1, and we had Border Television up on the Thursday night. Buzzbomb Willie Smith, you can't Willie, obviously, and Willie's still a great fan of the club, and he and my favourite players from back then. Border Telly came up on the Thursday night, and where we were sitting now, it was a quagmire behind the goals. That was a training area, and the Border Telly, they were asking Willie what he thought about the game tomorrow. And Willie's turning around going, are these guys stupid? The game's not a Saturday. Willie couldn't get it out of his head that he was being interviewed to go out on the show on the Friday night. The game's the morning. And I can remember how the interview sort of wound itself up. They asked Willie what he thought of the game would be, and he goes, it'll be a game of two halves. The interviewer looked at him and he goes, the first and the second. And we have many laughs about that nowadays, but Willie couldn't think of what to say. Cameras at Gallabank in the late 70s were just unknown, but we lost that game 3-1 and I sold the pies. I think I maybe ate half of them. We took over 100 quid away back then and selling pies in Bovril. We never even had an area, a proper kitchen area. It was just inside the old tractor shed. But it was Francis's pies back then, just like it is nowadays. So, it goes away back to then, and that was just, I got involved through Ginger. I worked with Ginger at Cochrane's, and that was it. And then after that, it just became a love affair.
Indeed, have you done literally every role at the club? Just about.
I've done most things. involved with the reserves. With Jumbo ex-chairman as well. I was assistant to him, then ran the reserves. Pretty much done most things. I loved it.
I always hear stories of when he used to go across to Ireland for the trips.
The trips to Ireland, the ambush, that was a classic. We'll never leave that in for a class there. There was another one, went to Ireland, the police pulled the bus in, picked Kyan up, stuck him in the cells on the Friday night and let him out on the Monday. So he spent the whole weekend in the clink. But Kyan, what a hero he was. And he used to come and he said, "Junkie, what is it? I'm cod. What is it? And I'd say, "You're a physiotherapist." There was a couple of Fs in there as well. And the guy's, "Bucket man." So way back then, Kyan was the bucket man to Sammy in the first team. And Ginger would probably, he'd still be playing then. Dropped into the reserves and we played Lochmaben this day in the reserves. Ginger picked the ball up inside his own box and he beat everybody. And he gets to about the penalty spot with the Lochmaben keeper he beat, and he burst out laughing and he says to the keeper, "You don't know what I'm going to do you?" and he burst out laughing and ballooned the ball over the bar. So oh gosh, the memories and stuff away back then. And it's amazing, but to see where the club came from, the pitch, the slope, and the pitch we all came, but the slope, you'd play on the slope, and we got that changed to the plastic pitch, and the stand behind the goals. Well, that was a cracking story. When we developed the ground, the plastic pitches were going to Stranraer and Dumfries. That's the way the council. See the council? Bad boys, they boys in the council, but. There was going to be a vote, and we'd got wind of this, and I thought we were going to lose out here, because Annan always being the sort of poor relation to Dumfries and Stranraer, third in the pecking order, that type of thing. So the Scottish Government at the time sponsored the League Cup, and they got it the Communities Cup, and Kenny McCaskill was the Justice Secretary, and he came down to our game, so he got the short straw, he got Annan and Fermor, and we just started talking, and sitting in the corner of the lounge there, he was asking about the plastic pitches, and he asked, "What would it take to get the third pitch?" I said, "Probably 200,000. And if you put that in the pot, that would be enough for the council then to put all three through." Well, two weeks later, the Scottish Government had a meeting in Stranraer, a remote meeting. They were going around the country at the time, and he stood on the steps of the town hall area there and announced another £250,000 funding. And that was us getting the plastic pitch.
Yeah, yeah.
So the way that went, I thought, well, that's great. And I pretty much spent 10 weeks up here for the whole duration of the project. I never done any work. I just came here every morning. I think Liz thought I was going to the right to the office, but I came here every day. And just the week before, we had a pre-contract meeting with the council and the main contractor. And I'm going through the park. I'm looking in the park now. I couldn't find the covered terracing. And I goes, "What's happened to the covered terracing?" "Oh, we can't afford it." Well, I kind of lost my temper a wee bit. A couple of swear words banged the table, and there'd be diggers and excavators and whatever else in a gallivanting Monday morning. "That's it, the job's cancelled, you're not getting in. You can't do that." I says, "Well, wait and see." Mm-hmm. And well, it was quite a lot more expletives than that. But anyway, I lost the tatty a wee bit. And I said, "You better get somebody on the phone that can make a decision." So we got somebody on the phone, they came and joined the meeting, and we got our covered terracing. For that whole project, I think as a club, we only paid something like £7,000 in a £700,000 project. Christ. And they were absolutely sick of me, because the contractor that was doing the work would come to me and see what we'd get done. I'd get thrown by a sign. as you would. So, that was a good time. And that was the start of the transformation as to where we are now, and now that we're a league club. And I think where we are as a club, it really is, we should be looking to the next step, and I think that's the big challenge going forward.
You touched on it there, but you personally were a massive driving factor to get us into the league, because you always, I can always been speaking to you in the past, and that's it, that's where we're going, that's what we're wanting to do when you were chairman, that was going to be your thing, and you did it.
It was the driver.
Obviously a lot of help as well, but personally, looking, I honestly thought it was, you were the driving factor, because you had that passion for the club to make it go forward.
That's where I saw the club, I saw us progressing, and I really hated the system at the time, that it was a closed door, closed shop, and you had no chance of getting in, it was only a vote to get in. And as it happened, we got in through a vote anyway, but I really had that drive for years and years. That was my vision for the club. I saw that's where we could go, and we got there, but it was a team effort getting there. But we did get there. We won the vote 17-12, it wasn't. The 12 clubs were pretty much all for the north of Scotland that voted against us, and they all voted for Cove. And at that time, Cove didn't even have a ground, and Cove's ground had been condemned. The SFL had said that they couldn't play there, and they wouldn't pass any criteria, and still 12 clubs voted for them, which that kind of sums up as well how the clubs, once they get in, sort of look at the bigger picture. They tend to just self-preservation, that's what it was. But no, we did get in, and funny enough, there was two committee members at that time, and I'm going to name them, Ginger and Terry O'Donnell, that voted against us joining. Ginger said we weren't ready, but and speaking to Ginger, I speak to him an awful lot, but that's the last thing that Ginger would ever want for us to go out of the league. So, but no, back then, we came down the steps with Hampden, having got in the joined the league, the SFL as it was in those days, and I thought, what have I done? We had £40,000 in the development fund, and the following day I placed the order for the floodlights, and they were 120. And we got the floodlights, and I said we'd have them up for the 30th of September. They were actually up and operating for the 1st of October, and they were paid in full. And see, that paid in full at that point, that's where the town came together. And once we got in the league, the number of locals and businesses that actually supported the club. And when we joined the league, we had something like 120 advertising boards around that pitch. Right. And that's maybe going forward where we need to look at, is to get the town and everybody back with the club and get that identity back again. Right. And once you get that, that can be the, I suppose, the step that, the first step that we need to take, and it would be a good foundation just to get that back, and I'd love to see that again.
I think this leads nicely on to what you've been doing outside after football. You're talking like a counsellor.
Talking like a counsellor.
But you've been involved with a bit of that, obviously.
I've always been able to talk. I think that once, when we joined the league, we got a civic award, and doing at the Toon Hall, and on behalf of the club, the council gave the club an award, and for 15 minutes I spoke about an athletic with no notes. So I've always had that ability to talk, but yeah, I've been a councillor the last 4 years. I think being chairman of the club probably put me in a good stead for that, but yeah, I've got another year to go before next year's election. A lot of things happen in 5 years. I think it's unlikely that I'll stay on. I think I'll do my 5 years, and
enjoyed it.
There's times that it's been quite demanding.
Testing.
But, it's testing, yeah. It's difficult when you're used with certain ways of working in your profession, and then you go into the council, and it's no like dealing with normal people in a normal job. And I'm not trying to be too unkind saying that, it's almost like an institution. But I'll do my 5 years and then come back and just support Anne in the
future. Would you ever like to get back involved with Anne in the future?
You can never say never, but I still miss it. I miss it every day when it's been part of your life. It's, I think as well, when I say part of my life, it was my life, and far too many times I put Anne in before everything else. And when I look back in reflection, I've done it. Would I change it? Nah, I wouldn't change it. I loved it. That's brilliant.
Well, Chunky, thank you very much for coming in and helping us out with this. It's been a pleasure to talk to you. It's great seeing you about the club again.
I'm
hope you enjoy the game.
Delighted to be here. The game's not going to mean anything, but big challenges now is getting the squad right for next year.
Exactly.
And everything else.
Brilliant.
Right. Brilliant, guys.
Thank you very much.